Hi there. So it's been a while. I've been thinking about how to do this and everything, and so I thought I'd condense the thing into doing it just like once a month, because once a week it's a little much. Things don't change that much in a week, although sometimes they do. Welcome back to La Ferme de Lettres. As you can see, it's a beautiful afternoon, and I'll show you what's happening with my babies, which are getting huge. I'll start with the greenhouse. In the greenhouse, it's become a jungle. So we'll have a look in there and I'll show you what's happening. Here we are. There we go. As you can see, it's become quite a jungle. Let's go in through it for in a detail. These are green beans. I harvested a big bag of them this morning. They're kind of all over the place. It's all kind of growing together. There are tomatoes that are starting to get very big here. There's a whole bunch of flowers. I think they're called Belle de Nuit, Beauties of the Night. These are Bois Gourmand, you can see there. And this is Borage, Clematites. This is Desmodium, it's a detox plant, which is just grown back from last year, but I also planted it. These are potatoes that just are flowering. So when they finish flowering, they'll be able to give me some potatoes. The ginger is kind of in there, but it's hidden. Here it is. I don't know if you can see it. It's the thin leaves in the back. And look at this beauty, this is a cucumber. It's just starting to flower. And beautiful flower. And it's growing up really big with these huge leaves. I made strings going from the roof so that it's climbing up the string, as I did for the tomatoes as well. Did it here, and behind there you have the turmeric growing well. These are all the Pois Gourmand, the Mange Tout peas, which got a little bit dry at one point, but they're growing again. I had to go away and it was really hot, but they're still there, they're still growing. And these are passion flowers, which are about to flower. It's become huge, like a jungle. And all these will become flowers very soon, incredible violet flowers. It's going up right up to the roof. The coriander has bolted, which is fine. I'll keep it for seeds, and then I'll be able to plant them again or use them as well for cooking. And I'll plant some more so that I get some more leaves again. Really pretty, it's kind of like dentelle. Remember the sweet potatoes that I planted a while back? I think it was maybe in my last video or the one before. I think it was the last video. They were little tiny, like just a couple of leaves. Well, look at them now. Yeah, they are, they're doing really well. And I think I'm going to plant them outside in the next couple of days or so. They should be happy. Here's the Artemisia. Artemisia annua is incredible. I replanted that, and I just replanted some more here. So I've got lots to plant outside. They smell incredible. I still have a whole bunch of kale and cabbage that I'm going to plant in the wild part of the garden and just see what happens. And here's some basil. I've already planted a whole bunch of it outside, but there's a whole much more here which I can give to friends, and I'll plant some more of it out. And look behind here, look at these tulsi ramas, these sacred basils. Look at that beauty. Isn't she lovely? And I'm going to plant her outside. I've already planted a few outside. They were smaller. I have a feeling they're going to do better because they're big here. For the last month or so, I've been able to eat pretty much solely from the greenhouse, which is really great, with green beans and mange tout, and also from kale from the garden. So that's quite a wonderful feeling to be able to kind of eat off your own land. That was my aim. So I'm starting to get there. Not a lot of variety yet, but very soon there will be. And now I'm going to show you the vegetable patch, because that's really come along. You saw me planting planting all the things when they were little tiny seedlings, little tiny babies, and now things have really evolved. Here we've got eggplants and green beans together. Remember, I was doing all this companion planting. So the green beans here will give the earth a nitrogen rich, which the eggplant loves. And same goes for a lot of other things like the zucchini courgettes, which were over here and are starting to flower. Look at that. And they're starting to make little courgettes. Look at those. They're not babies anymore, they're mothers. And look at those beautiful babies that they're making. Underneath the courgettes, the zucchinis, I put some basil, because basil doesn't like too much sun. They like a lot of warmth, not too much sun. So the leaves from the zucchini, the courgettes, they kind of like give them some shade. And at the same time, they attract the good insects. And they get rid of the bad ones, like, well, not bad, but the ones that tend to attack, like ants. Basil repels ants. Ants don't like basil. The tomato patch, I think I have about 30 tomato plants outside and probably about 6 or 7 inside. So there's going to be a lot of tomatoes at one point. And I planted them with, I think it's butternut, and borage. And basil. It's good to mix things like this, and there's some rosemary somewhere as well. And I'll be planting, I think, my sweet potatoes, I think they'll go here, because they'll cover the floor, and like covering the floor, they'll keep the humidity in. So you won't need to water hardly at all with the, between the hay and things. There's some nasturtiums here as well. Obviously in life, not everything is a big success, and sometimes you have failures. But from your failures, you learn. You learn, you know, what to do, or you question yourself and you move on. So the patch that's here is a little bit of a disappointment because I didn't prepare it as well. So, you know, you get what you reap. You sow what you reap what you sow. and also there's a nut tree, a walnut tree, which is just over it, which is casting shade, and also probably the roots are seeping nutrition out of the soil. So this is a patch where I planted potatoes, sweet corn, peas, and quinoa. So the quinoa was not a big success anyway. And now I'm going to show you the last vegetable plot, where there is a lot of kale, there is cabbage, there is black corn, peas, butternut, there is green beans and cucumbers, and a melon and watermelon. So there you have it for the vegetables and the fruit. I had a ton of fruit. Of cherry trees were just like full. They still are, but they've kind of turned into cherry alcohol now, I'm afraid. Next year I'll be more organized and I'll freeze them, or I'll figure out some way to distribute them more. I gave them to as many people as I could. As you can see behind me, there is still a lot of them in there. I don't know if you can see that. And but they're starting to get alkalized. It's actually might be a nice idea to make cherry wine. Never thought about it before, but when I was tasting some of them, it tasted like some kind of Lambrusco or something. The prune season, plum season, as they say. I'll show you those. They're here. And little tiny plums that are really delicious too. I don't want to bore you too much, but I just wanted to show you one last thing. Last weekend, last Sunday, I actually took the time to fast and to be at the Ferme de Lettres. The Ferme de Lettres, I'm really the farm of being, and I actually never really have the time to do that. So I fasted for 2 days, and the first day I really just spent like sitting in different places in the circle, which I'm going to show you now, and in the forest under the cherry trees. And just meditating and thinking and reading and sleeping and just being. And it was such a wonderful experience. We hardly ever do that. I don't know about you, but I hardly ever actually take the time to just be. And it's a very regenerating experience. I recommend it.
I brought you something close to me. Left with something new. See through your head. You haunt my dreams. There's nothing to do but believe. Just believe. Just breathe.
Well, I hope you enjoyed the show, and if you are not already subscribed, feel free to subscribe, feel free to like, and I shouldn't even ask that actually. And I'm really happy to be able to share this with you, and I hope to be able to share it with you very soon again, probably in about a month's time. And I'm sure things will have evolved a lot.
I'm used to